You're my God, you're all to me. to the Lord tonight. Hallelujah. Let's all stand to our feet. Welcome the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords on the corner of Baker and Barnard. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come to you tonight, Lord, asking you for a mighty move of the Holy Ghost tonight. I pray, Lord God, for the drunk. I pray for the prostitute. I pray for the drug addict. I pray for the demon possessed. I pray for those that are bound by perversion tonight, that those chains and cords of darknesses will be broken. Lord, I ask you tonight, God, for a mighty harvest of soul. I ask you, Lord, for the bodies that are sick, Lord, that they be made whole, God. You are the same yesterday, today, and forever. And what you did in the Bible is what you do now. God, I pray for a mighty outpouring of your Holy Spirit tonight, God. Touch every heart, every life, God. Touch those, God, in the alleys, those in the apartment, those in the businesses, those listening on the outskirts, God. They're not hearing this tonight by accident, but God, tonight I ask you that you would minister, God, that you would move, Lord, in a mighty way, Lord. We can do nothing in our own power. It's not by might nor by power, but it's by my Spirit, saith the Lord of hosts. Father, have your way tonight. We give you the praise, the glory, and the honor. In Jesus' name, and everybody said, amen, amen. Let's sing, Yes, I Know. Hallelujah. How many of you know tonight that Jesus' blood has the power to wash away even the darkest stains of sin? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come, you say, lost and broken. Amazing love. I'm forgiven. more song tonight. Before we move any further in the service tonight, let's just sing, "This Is My Desire." Hallelujah, hallelujah. And to touch your life, there is only one answer, one hope. When cure for your life, and that is a born again relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. There are some things in this life that nothing can ever help you with. You can't go to man to get delivered from drugs. You can't go to man to be delivered from alcohol. You can't go to a psychologist or psychiatrist to be set free from a spirit of perversion. But all of these things are easily broken in the presence of the King. That's why the Bible says where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. There's liberty to worship Him, liberty to praise Him, liberty to live for Him. You cannot live a holy life without Jesus being the Lord and the Savior of your life. That's why the Bible declared today, if you hear His voice, harden not your heart. You never know when that last moment in time could come. You never know when you'll have to stand before a holy God. But there's good news for you and I that are here tonight. You that are under the sound of the voice of the Holy Ghost tonight. God is here and He offers you a new life tonight. The Bible says if any man, no matter who it is, any man, woman, boy, or girl, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Them old things are passed away, and behold, all things are become new. Only through Jesus. I don't offer you a church program. I don't offer you this and that. I give you what the apostle Peter gave. He said, silver and gold have I not, but such as I do have, I give it to you in the name of Jesus. It's up to you and I to decide what we're going to do with the gospel. Like I said, today if you hear His voice, harden not your heart. When you stand before Him, you won't have any excuse to give. Tonight, God is speaking to your heart, and He says, I love you. I can forgive you. I can cleanse you. I can wash you. You must call upon the name of the Lord. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's sing one more song tonight. One more song unto the King before we get into the Word of God. For He is Jesus Lord, but by the Holy Ghost, it takes a born-again relationship to know Jesus as Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, praise God. Amen. You love Jesus tonight. Amen. Let's give the Lord one more hand clap of praise tonight.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. You ready for the Word tonight? Hallelujah. 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 Praise God.
Hallelujah. It is always an honor and a privilege to be able to come out here the last Sunday night of the month and to preach the Word of God unto you. You may say, why are you doing this? We ain't doing it to be seen. We ain't doing it just to make a ruckus or anything like that. We're doing this because the Bible says to go out and to compel them to come in that my house might be feel. Some of you, you'll never step foot in this church. But tonight you can hear the Word of God. And the Bible says that the Word of God, it can change you. It can deliver you. It can set you free. Jesus said this, if you can believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. Have you ever faced a situation in your life where you needed a miracle? Have you ever faced a situation in your life when you didn't know how you were going to make it? You didn't know how you were going to be free. You didn't know how you were going to make it through. Let me tell you, if that's you tonight, there's good news. Jesus is here and he desires to help you. Can you say amen tonight? That's why we're out here. We're called New Hope Church. We're bringing a message of hope to you. There's no hope within a building. There's no hope in a pope. No hope in water baptism. No hope in religion. There is only hope in a relationship. And that relationship is with God's Son, Jesus Christ. Can you say amen? Hallelujah. So let's go ahead and get on into the Word tonight. I want to preach out of the book of Isaiah. The book of Isaiah is towards the middle of your Bible. The book of Isaiah, chapter number 1 tonight. Praise God. I want to preach what God gave me for these that are here tonight. Those that are listening. Isaiah chapter number 1 and verse number 18. Listen to what the Word of God says. Isaiah 1:18. Come now, let us reason together, saith the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. If ye be willing and obedient, ye shall eat of the good of the land. But if ye refuse and rebel, ye shall be devoured with the sword. For the word or the mouth of the Lord hath spoken it. Church, let's pray one more time. Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you for your anointing. Lord, I am nothing in myself but a frail human vessel. But God, tonight I desire that you would use this vessel. I know your word says that there's treasure in earthen vessels. And God, I pray that this treasure, the gospel of Jesus Christ, would be brought forth tonight. And God, that it would have a lasting impact. Impact our hearts tonight. Change us. Make us seek after you. In Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. And amen. Hallelujah. You know, every day we are faced with decisions in life. The first decision you're faced with every day, or at least that I'm faced with, is should I get out of bed or should I just press snooze on my phone? Should I go here or should I go there? Should I do this or should I do that? You see, every single day we're faced with decisions. There are some decisions that really won't affect you either way. I'm not talking about whether or not I'll eat Fruity Pebbles or I'll eat cornflakes. No, no, no. Fruity Pebbles is the right choice. But I'm talking about there are some decisions that'll have an eternal impact upon your life. I believe tonight that as we're preaching the Word of God, as you hear the gospel, you are being faced with a decision. Should I listen to what this preacher has to say, or should I ignore him and try to find something else to do? I'm here to tell you tonight, you can run from me, but you cannot run from God, the Holy Ghost. God, the Holy Ghost knows how to go where no man can go. Thank God, even the Holy Ghost can go into the places in your heart where you're hurting, where you're broken, and he knows how to fix you. He knows how to mend you. Can you say amen? But even right now, we're being faced with decisions, but the decisions that we make tonight could have an eternal impact on where we will spend eternity. You see, there's no such thing as purgatory. There's no such thing as reincarnation. There's no such thing as just annihilation. But once you die, the Bible said, it's appointed unto a man once to die, and after that, the judgment. Will you, whenever you die, do you know for a certainty that you would wake up in the presence of the Lord? Or would you be terrified if you died tonight? Would you not know where you were going going to spend eternity. You said, would a loving God throw a person in hell? You better believe he would. Yes, he will. The Bible says that there will be some when Jesus will say, you said you did this in my name, but I never knew you. Depart from me, ye worker of iniquity. But I'm thankful tonight that isn't going to be said of me. Why? Because I've been walking in the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sin and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. You may be here listening, you may be at home, but all you've got to do to be saved is simply cry out to that name of Jesus. Say, Jesus, I'm sorry for my sin. Wash me, cleanse me. I repent. Come into my life. And God at that moment will take every sin of your past, those things nobody else knows about but you, the worst and wickedest of all sin. God will take them. He'll throw them into the depths of the sea, never to be brought up again. That's the love of God. You can't find that kind of love in a bar. You can't find that kind of love in a relationship. You can only find that kind of love through a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. God is love.
God is love. Romans 14:11, for as it is written, as I say, saith the Lord, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall confess to God. One day the atheist will bow their knee. One day the Jew will bow their knee. One day the Muslim will bow their knee. One day the Catholic will bow their knee, and they will confess Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the
That's something that cannot be changed. Why? Because the Word of God says so. The Bible says, forever, O Lord, thy word is settled in heaven. Hallelujah. Come now. First thing tonight I want to mention is if you're thirsty, come now.